just over at Durban High School. Ooh. Crikey, that wind's strong. Oh dear. If I just signal the wide. Come on, Tom. There's no port. This looks pretty grim to me. Oh dear. See you later.
Look where he is now. Nowhere. Spending a lot of time picking the ball up from the boundary.
fire again for Tom. Runs, and this is the third over. Get back to you later. Now 51 of 7 overs. Well, that scoreboard's getting red hot. 57 off 7. Jesus. I'm going shopping. It's blowing a complete hurricane. Trouble with the bales keep getting blown off. Well, I've just returned. I've been away for an hour or so down the pub. Cares are still batting. This is the last over. Chris Tebbit's bowling. I'm going to now show you the scoreboard. 234 for three. 235 actually. Boy, these boys have had a tough game. The weather's now much cooler. Grey skies. Oh dear. How can Tebbit bowl a wide? These boys are really growing up with this South African cricket. Fine figure of an umpire. I had to leave, it was too painful to stay and watch. There's the games master. I was actually going to go to England to play for Glamorgan. Good effort by Craig. Tough time for these guys. They've worked really hard with the boys. I hope they don't feel too let down. Battery's going. Young boy must have just got his 50. This must be the last over. Mr. Edge. Oops. Two for three for three. Another four crashes to the boundary. Some considerable pain. cooler, there you are. Right, this is the start of the Kez innings. Jack and Tim Boot. Tim Boot is his facer. And they're chasing 250 off 35 overs. I would suspect the task is a bit too much at this point. Here's the bowler. Somehow these boys seem so frail. Strangely as it sounds, compared to this lot. That's my boy. Dino. Stevie boy. Tebs. Oops, where are we? Hady, who's in great pain. Here comes the bowler. Bowl into young Jack. Two runs on the board.
Red.
There's a run. Third man. Here's the bowler from the other end. Young Jack is facing. Good player, Jack. Nice boy, I like him. Yeah, the bowler's running in. Jack's facing. One off the pads. Oh. Yes. Mr. B is sending them back for some strange reason. Looked like a perfectly valid run to me. these South Africans are mad about sport. Just look at them. This is the really big difference. People are voluntarily running. They must be mad. And all this cricket practice going on around here. Bowler's got a super run up. It's now 5 o'clock, and as you can see, not so good. Stephen Weimer and Max are batting. Good shot by Stephen. 4 runs. Tom's in next. Lean and mean. Kids here seem as happy as ever. Callum's having a good time. Looks like Stephen just made a good shot. Missed it as ever.
This is the guy that's only going for half a nap.
Is he Indian?
Yeah.
He's not really tall, is he?
No.
Very fast arm action.
That's off the half run up then.
Well, the opening bowler got a lovely action. Is that the same one?
Yeah, I think so. The opening bowler from which end?
From that end?
Yeah, that's him there.
Is that Stephen facing?
Yep.
Mm.
you going to go in?
Check all the lizards.
Okay.
Yeah, a bit of everyone, hopefully.
At the most, I'm going to have two.
There goes Tom. Four balls to go. What's the score, Tim? 73 for 6, chasing 250. Tom's got four balls within which to hit about 180.
You could do it.
Could be close.
Stephen's coaching him, look. He has had so much advice.
Spin it the ball. Hit it for 6.
Well, at least Tom's going to confuse them a little bit because he's left-handed.
I'm going to go in there, turn left.
You're not going to go in there, Chris.
Oh, that's a good point.
Oh, they know he's left-handed. How do they know that?
Post.
On
top of the post.
Sick bag.
What? Sick bag. That's what he said.
Mr. Edge, here he comes. First ball. Tom's facing his first ball.
Oh,
Tom.
And again. Go on. That's it, come on.
Yeah, Tom's keen, look. Two boys.
Tom's second.
That's it. I'm going to get one ball now at the most.
Come on. Here comes Bowler.
Yeah.
Good shot, Tom.
And he's already scored one more.
The ball just disappeared in the hedge. Tom got his first four on tour. Oh, no, he didn't. He got another one. The bishops. That's a nice shot, that one, round the corner. That was pretty awful, Tom. Is this the last ball?
It is the last ball.
Well, it's going to improve Tom's average, especially if he gets another four now.
What is his average?
Pretty dreadful. Well, that looked like a wide ball to me. Yep, signaled wide. Here comes the last ball. Oh. Did that bounce off the stumps?
No, it bounced off the bowl.
Oh, there's still one more ball to come. Tom's facing. God, he's on a roll.
He's got 6 runs.
Well, I don't know whether he hit it. He's going for it. Well, it's Keystone Cops out there. What's happening?
Missed the stumps. Missed the stumps because one just stood there.
Well, what happened? Did Stephen run or what?
Stephen stood in the wicket watching the throw. And then they missed the stumps.
Go down there then, Tim, shake hands with these boys. Seems to be there. That's it. For some reason, the battery's gone. Well, there's one of the maids coming up the hill.
very, very steep hill. Got the water on top of a hill. This is Westville High School. Just arrived. The ritual of unpacking the bags from the coach.
There's only 8 of them, so that's a good start.
That's what you could do with. Looks a good ground though, Tom.
Yeah, I know.
It's another super ground. So you've ever seen so much luggage in all your life?
Will, mate.
You're feeling a bit happier then, boy. Show us your nose, Will.
Come here.
Look at that.
Chopped off by a door.
Look at that for a nose.
A nose and a half.
Rudolph O'Brien.
Yeah, very funny, Joe. I have no problems once I've smashed your camera on the floor.
Tommy, recording.
Craig
Wincan,
then.
Look, you're recording.
Well, the coach has just dropped us off. There's the cricket ground down through there. The front gates of the school. It's quite a nice neighbourhood. All our luggage is off. Cricket master. This is the hosting process now, where the boys meet their hosts.
Douglas!
Shall we just work out who you're going to be with, even though they're not here yet? Is that okay? It's in your bags. It's in your hand. Okay.
Right, they've all got paired up. And now they move off.
Have we got somebody left to help?
And eventually we leave for somewhere too.
To it.
I am, I'm speaking quietly. Well, this is our last B&B so-called, and boy, have we hit the jackpot. This place is situated in a nature reserve, and is absolutely huge, with its own swimming pool. Down here, over the fence, down there is a river. That's the view from the balcony. The cliffs over there. There's a big bird up there somewhere, I can't see it. There's a man alone with his thoughts. You are? Ants. This is the room that Roy and I are going to share. Oh, Roy's in the bathroom. Up these three little steps. This is poor. They actually won the toss for the room, but kitchen area, fridge.
What? You're joking. Also, I'm going to go and see the nature reserve. Perhaps. Down the hill, up the hill and down here.
Well, yeah, exactly. Why not?
Are we allowed to drive?
These are the gardens.
I asked that point. You'd rather sort of just strip your shoulders at it. So,
well, if you're not going to go very far.
Hit the jackpot here. Where's the drive down to this house? It really is. Gillespie's. And that's the car we've got. Thrown in. There's like a little summer house overlooking the pool. Might have a swim. This is a little patio area leading into the owner's accommodation. Mr. Smallwood disappearing into his room. Right, I've got to go down the stairs and round the back there through the jungle.
Right, go on then, put your hand by it so we can see how big it is.
Have you seen this grasshopper?
Pick it up then, Paul, go on.
I'd rather
not.
Go on, Roy. It's got an ant attacking it at its back, look.
Yeah. Probably ill.
It doesn't look very... Oh, it's moving.
It's covered in ants.
Oh, it's ill. It's not very well.
That fly's following it too.
Yeah.
Oh dear.
Yeah, it is in trouble.
One has been for a swim. You've both been in the pool?
Yes. You're lying, toad.
Come on, hop.
That's the biggest bug I've ever seen. There you go. Well, this is the view from the swimming pool terrace. Down to the river. It really is very, very nice. This is a very nice room too, four poster, but apparently it's occupied tomorrow night. This is like real jungle. It's up on the hill, that house, other side of the ravine. Look at that. What day is it?
In fact, it could mistake you as one of its own.
What day is it, Rob?
Tuesday.
It's Tuesday the 4th of November. We're watching the telly. Good shot. Where's Mr. T? Mr. T has got a dose of Montezuma's revenge.
Acute.
Acute. The expeller is working
overtime.
Mr. B has got acute arachnophobia. Roy, as you can see, is perfectly relaxed. And I'm just about to go out on the White Hunter expedition. Relaxed. And I'm just going to go outside and take a bit of film. If the film gets wobbly, it's because there's something after me. Well, I'm out on the patio now. It's almost midnight. They're inside, completely frightened to come outside. I've just got a towel wrapped around my waist. There's gigantic ants on the floor. Can't see a damn thing. But can you hear the noise?
I don't know what I'm pointing the camera at because I can't see a thing. We're told there's lots of monkeys and they're going to come up onto the patio in the morning. Probably can't see a thing. This is probably completely blank. But can you hear the noise? I'm going to go in because if a monkey comes.
What's wrong with you?
Yeah.
Is this a
stupid.
Oh. Right. No. He ducked into it like this. Oh, that's so true.
And say something.
Oh, I think the cricket team's doing very well today. We've restricted them down to 203 overs for 7 wickets. We're doing very well at the moment.
203 overs.
Pardon?
You said 203 overs.
I meant the total was 203. And we've got 7 wickets. And how many overs we've got? 40 overs we've got. So we're doing pretty well.
Cool. Hang on, where's Dad? He's like a little blob in the distance. What? Hurry up, Sam.
Zooming on the ball.
I can't follow the ball. I'm gonna fade out. Now I'm zooming in on the fence.
get some music to.
Quality special effect here, especially with the speed of this.
Well, Tom's batting, it's now 4 o'clock. The team have been absolutely thrashed. And Tom is batting at number 12, actually. Out of the way, Chris.
Bug, I'm sorry. I'm in, yeah? Oh, he's got it! Oh,
genie! Tom's got a genie! And there's Tom was out.
Tom got a genie! Alright, Max, 13's in now. Max, hurry up. 13's in now.
That's a long walk, Tom. For nothing. A long walk, Tom. Where's he going now? Tom, where are you going? Where? Well, there's Edgy batting at number 14 or 15.
Did you record me? No, because you was asleep.
Yeah, I nodded off, I think. Well, that's gone for 4 something or others. Go on, Chris, give it a whack. It looks like more buyers. A very sad story.
Well done, Max.
I thought it was Steve Dayton, though, first.
Is it?
Is he? Alright, I thought it was coming next.
Very nice facilities again. That actually should read 50 for about 14.
And the ball's in the bin. Well, post-match photograph.
Yay! 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 Y two, and
well, here we are for about our fifth braai after the game. Tom's playing cricket still, but the rest of the boys are all playing football. I don't know what the score is at football. Chris Edge just saved it. We're down to the last 5 minutes of this tape, which means I've got a completely free one for the game part tomorrow. It's now 6 o'clock. Where are the fires? Getting ready for steak, chop, sausage, rice, salad, the whole thing. I think the boys are having a brilliant time. Oh, could be a goal. It's a goal.
Yeah, possibly in the classroom or with the management or whatever.
No, it's never. It's,
well, does someone want to give me a quick, yeah, quick summary of what you're doing then?
Burning meat, burning carved up animals.
It's a pagan, pagan African ritual. It's bound to increase the fertility in anybody who
especially
partakes.
Put me down for 10 then. Because I've never seen this much meat together in one place before.
And cooked to perfection.
Yeah. Well, when my these
guys all come from Brixton.
Yeah. Well, when my wife sees this lot, that's about 5,000 francs worth you've got there. Yummy, yummy. Right, I'm going to turn it off now because I'm going to have a beer and have something to eat. Bye, dear. Well, everything is prepared with customary South African efficiency. All the meat is cooked, the salad, the rice, the bread. I think we're just going to have some short presentation. This is part of the pavilion. And all the boys are going to come in here and trough. Presentation time.
It's really been a pleasure having you guys out here. The cricket today, we enjoyed the cricket. Perhaps a little bit more than you did, but I'm sure that it would have been a good learning experience for you. Some of you guys really performed well. I think it was Jake or Jack, yeah, bowling from my end.
Jack.
It was an excellent bowling performance, I must say. Very well done. Also, Rudolph over there, great batting performance as well. Stayed out there for a long time. Well done, Rudolph. Like I say, it's been a pleasure on behalf of Westville Boys High to have you out here as a touring side. Coaches as well as players. I've had a little bit of feedback from guys on my side, and they've enjoyed having you as their guests as well.
Thank you guys for coming out here. Good. We enjoyed it. I don't know about you guys. And I'd like to give this to your captain, James.
James.
So thank you very much to the parents who put us up.
tremendous hospitality once again, and also thank you to the lads for the game. That's been something which we can aspire to, and the way you played it was tremendous, and we just hope that we can reach your level one day.
A few thank yous on behalf of Zinger D7 High School. Firstly, a big thank you to Westfield for inviting us to come and play here. Throughout this tour, we've been lucky to play cricket at some tremendous venues, and to finish our tour in a setting like this has been absolutely tremendous. the school for the hospitality that they extended.
Tape is just about to run out.
And also for the entertainment that they provided us with while we've been here. So Mike for taking us out for dinner last night, which was excellent. And also, and as we move from one place to another, we were quite astounded by the hospitality that we were offered. And when we arrived here and found that we were actually even given the use of a car, and that just about topped everything. But a marvellous thank you for that.